So I'm a toxicologist with the Food Safety and Inspection Service in the Office of Public Health Science. And what I'm going to talk to you today is I'm just going to show you a general overview of what metals have been found in food, different food products that FSIS and FDA regulates. So the title of my talk is Presence of Metals in Various Food Products. I'm going to give you a little bit of introduction on metals. I don't define what a metal is. I suppose many people do, but if you want to shout it out, that's fine too. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about what the Food Safety and Inspection Service does when it comes to sampling for metals, about what the FDA does when it comes to their type of sampling for metals. And I'm going to show you some data from our sampling and from FDA sampling that shows the different metals that could be in different food products. I have to make a data disclaimer. The data that I'm presenting is, like I said, from FDA and FSIS. The data is publicly available, which is why you'll see there's a cutoff of the years, because the last public data that FSIS has goes up to 2012. And then the metals that I chose to speak about, since there's a lot of them, I decided to cut it off by depending on the sensitivity of the methods that we have in our labs. This is a periodic table of elements. As you know, there's 118 elements, and about 91 of them are metals. The ones in the black box are the ones that our agency, Food Safety and Inspection Service, samples for. The ones in the green boxes are what FDA and FSI samples for. What's in the blue boxes, it's only what FDA samples, and they sample for more than what FSI samples for. And then the ones in the red boxes are the ones that I'm presenting on, and they're sampled both by FDA and FSIS. We've heard about news articles or either in the newspaper or in the news about what metals have been found or described in different food products. As you all know, it has been documented or said that arsenic is found in rice, chicken, and wine recently, and it's that arsenic is distributed through plants, or it's a metabolite of a veterinary drug that it's actually being removed from the market by FDA. Methylmercury has been found in fish, especially from spills that happened in the Minamata Bay in Japan. Cadmium has been commonly found in leafy vegetables, and lead used to be used as a sweetener in wine during Roman times. What are the sources of metals, and how are humans exposed? Most of our exposure is through the diet, although there's occupational exposure to different metals. When it comes to animal exposure, it's either through the animal feed, through veterinary drugs, or just through the environment, either in the soil, the water, or the air that they breathe. And when it comes to plant exposure, it's just through soil, so they take up some of the metals. Some of the metals are not taken up, but some are. So what's FSIS? FSIS is the public health agency within the USDA that's responsible for ensuring that the nation's commercial supply of meat, poultry, and egg products is safe, wholesome, and correctly labeled and packaged. And FSIS is one of the participants in what's called the National Residue Program. It was established in 1967, and the NRP protects the nation from chemical hazards that might be in the meat and poultry products. It analyzes various tissues for the presence of trace elements. We do have different tiers of sampling. Tier one sampling is basically what's scheduled throughout the year, and it's randomly chosen. The sample's randomly chosen. And then tier two sampling is what's called inspector-generated sampling, which public health veterinarians, they select the animal to sample for based on their professional judgment. So this is what we sample for. We use atomic absorption spectroscopy for arsenic. We use inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometry, and we use that technique to sample for cadmium, cobalt, manganese, molybdenum, lead, selenium, and thallium. And then we use inductively coupled plasma optical emission spectrometry to sample for aluminum, barium, boron, chromium, copper, iron, nickel, strontium, vanadium, and zinc. What about the Food and Drug Administration? So the FDA, it protects the public health by assuring that foods other than meat, poultry, and egg products, which is what FSI samples for, are safe, wholesome, sanitary, and properly labeled. Within the FDA, they sample using the what's called a total diastole, or what used to be called the market basket survey. It's an ongoing FDA program that determines the levels of virus contaminants and nutrients in foods. It was established in 1961 to monitor for radiation in foods. However, it now monitors for pesticide residues, industrial chemicals, and toxic and nutrient elements. This is the process. They purchase samples of food from the market out in commerce, and then they prepare the food as if a consumer would be cooking it. Then they analyze that food for contaminants and nutrients. And then after that, they calculate the dietary exposure based on average consumption amounts for the food products. And I believe one of our speakers is gonna show an example of dietary exposure assessments. These are the metals that the total diastole samples for. They sample for arsenic, cadmium, calcium, copper, iron, lead, magnesium, manganese, mercury, nickel, potassium, selenium, sodium, and zinc. And they also sample for phosphorus and iodine, which are not metals, but they sample for them. So now I'm going to get into some data that that I gathered from the Food Safety and Inspection Service, the National Residue Program, and the Total Diastole. The first piece of data, the top panel, is cadmium and lead. And this data is from 2012, because this is the last year that we've put something out in the public. But right now, we're waiting for data from 2013 and 2014 to come out. It's in the clearing process right now. And I can update you when that comes out so that you can see the data. But as you can see, cadmium was only found in the kidneys of market hogs. From 70 samples taken, 70 were positive. But none other samples out of 628 showed any positives. When it comes to lead, only about six samples came back positive out of a total of 569. And then for arsenic, no arsenic was found in any market hogs out of 67 samples. These are the concentration ranges that were identified from the sampling. Out of the 70 samples in kidneys or market hogs, the range is from 20.74 to 424.74 parts per billion, and the mean is around 137.9. Then the only sample in beef cow's muscle was 33.94, and the only sample from muscle in sows was 30.48, and then there's a range for the four positive samples in market hogs, from 32.84 to 102.20, the mean being 66.87. Now, this is actually the first time that I looked at the total diastole, so I didn't know really what to do with the data. There's a lot of data in the total diastole for every metal, for every product type out there. So I decided to condense it in such a way that sort of makes sense. So this table here shows you the metals that FSI samples for that have a high sensitivity in our methods. And what I'm showing you is the number of product types that tested positive for that metal and the total amount of products that they sampled for. So as you can see, the top, the metal that's mostly found is lead, followed by cadmium, and then selenium, followed then by manganese and arsenic, and then molybdenum is the last one. I'm going to show you, and then these next slides are going to show you the top three food products that those metals were found in. So you can see that for arsenic, the top three products are granola bar, chicken, and chicken breast, and chicken legs. And then for cadmium, you find it in apple pies, oatmeal, popcorn, pinto beans, cereal, chicken legs, coleslaw. And then lead is found in chocolate syrup, apricots, canned sweet potatoes, and baby food grape juice. And then you have manganese. Manganese is found in a lot of the products. However, it wasn't the top metal that showed up in more products, but it shows up. These are the top three product types per metal. So you can find manganese in peach, pear, tomato juice, cantaloupes, soups, baby food made of pears, clam chowder, apricots, corn, watermelon, peaches, mushrooms, beef, and vegetable stew. And then you have molybdenum. It's found in beef liver, pinto beans, crisp rice cereal, oat ring, white beans, granola bars, shredded wheat cereal. Selenium is found in many other products too. half and half cream. I don't know who drinks coffee, but it's found in milk, corn, beef, and vegetables too, salad dressing. Now, I presented to you some data that FDA and FSIS have found, metals found in food products, but that doesn't really matter until you do a dietary exposure assessment, because you don't know how much you're consuming. You know you're consuming the metal in different product types, but you don't know how much you're consuming. So Paracelsus, he's the father of toxicology. He said, "Dosis facit venenum," which means that the dose makes a poison. So the concentration that I show you don't matter until you do a dietary exposure assessment and tells you how much you're consuming of the metal, which might pose a health risk or not. So I know somebody's presenting, like I said earlier, on a dietary exposure assessment. And this is just a depiction of what I just said. As you can see, the guy is just getting some probably wheat grains thrown on him, which don't affect him. But then if you throw the bag once, it could be affected. So now I want to thank Dr. Charlie Santer for making me wanting to come here. And I appreciate him giving me the enthusiasm to come. Stephanie Bruguglio and Chris Sack, they work at the FDA. They work closely on the total diet study, and they helped me look at it and try to interpret it. Dr. Patty Bennett, she used to be my supervisor, and she was really helpful in helping me out. And Mansi for just inviting me over here. So if there's any questions, I'll take them now. Thank you. And here's my email in case anybody wants to ask me about metals.